Penguin Random House Audio presents Fearfully and Wonderfully Made, The Astonishing New Science of the Senses by Maureen Seaberg. Read for you by Cindy Kay. This book grew from a series of articles I co-wrote with William C. Bushell, PhD, and our respective work on the senses. An MIT-affiliated biophysical anthropologist for 26 years, Bushell is one of the world's leading experts on adept meditators and humans with exceptional performance. He first pointed out to me the uptick in research into the senses. Bushell has a savant-like bird's-eye view of such things, with more than 40 years of delving into and building on the related literature. I'm honored that he has been my friend and mentor for more than a decade, together exploring the cosmic existential soup, as he puts it. Thank you, Bill. If the doors of perception were cleansed, everything would appear to man as it is, infinite. For man has closed himself up, till he sees all things through narrow chinks of his cavern. William Blake, The Marriage of Heaven and Hell. For I am fearfully and wonderfully made, marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. Psalm chapter 139, verse 14. Introduction. The smell of the earth after rain. The electric hues of a fiery sunset. The zest of cardamom in a cup of chai. Frissons along your cheek from the brush of a hand. The first few bars of your favorite song. Smell, sight, taste, touch, and hearing. Together, these and other senses form our perception and give meaning to life. They do not just convey all that is beautiful. They are far more powerful than we know. Contrary to lingering myths, humans perceive things as well as or better than other animals and any machine. Astonishing recent studies reveal that we can see light at the level of a single photon. Hear sounds at amplitudes smaller than the diameter of an atom. Use the vibrations of electrons to smell a trillion or more scents. Taste fresh water. And feel the difference of a single molecule of thickness on a smooth surface. Our sensory systems, or sensoria, operate on an atomic and even subatomic scale. Yet we tend to think quantum mechanics is out there somewhere, in some faraway place, where the tiny things of physics do their mysterious dance through space and time. Or we associate quantum phenomena with an underground tunnel in Switzerland, where scientists work to find God particles. At the very least, quantum theory calls to mind a high-tech laboratory off-limits to everyday people, the wheelhouse of Albert Einstein and his colleagues. But the quantum is all around us and inside us. We are part of it. What if we could understand the infinitesimal through our own experiences? And what if we recalibrated our expectations? Our very lives to match these newly discovered potentials. How far could we progress? Would the impossible become possible? Would our senses save us? It is already happening, and people are making scientific breakthroughs one could call miraculous. We need to develop what I call our perception quotient, or PQ, a type of intelligence fundamental to our survival. Central to the quotient is perceptual awareness, getting back in touch with and nurturing our abilities. The good news is that the senses are plastic and PQ can be expanded. After immersing myself in the research and many first-person testimonies for this book, I've put together a roadmap with 10 clear steps to take. You can find that model with the handy acronym perception in chapter 14. I turn to people who can sense at superpower levels to show the way. One stunning example is Joy Milne, a retired nurse in Scotland, known for her ability to smell Parkinson's disease. She detected a change in her husband's odor 6 years before he was diagnosed with the devastating illness. now researchers have found ways to use molecular biomarkers to detect the disease early on, which will allow doctors to intervene years before the worst symptoms set in. When I interviewed Milne, she revealed she's also able to smell COVID and is working with researchers on that incredible development. Milne's abilities were not recognized until later in her life when science caught up to these potentials. I'm sure there are more people like her waiting to be discovered, and more people who could become like her through awareness and training. The other senses are just as promising. In the case of vision, we're heading toward a day when human perception may unlock the ultimate secrets of the universe. Researchers recently proved that humans can detect a single photon of light with the unaided eye. The subjects in this study were not super seers, but three men with typical vision. One even wore contact lenses. Scientists are now working to discover if humans can see photons in superposition and entanglement. Will they see what has been theorized, or something else? We're on the brink of looking at the fabric of the cosmos. Now that we are finding out about our true sensory natures, what else is possible? Maybe humans will discover a new kind of physics and make an enormous leap forward in space travel. Maybe doctors will learn how to smell cancer at the earliest stages and treat patients immediately. More children may develop super abilities if their education is based on the latest research. And philosophically, by combining all these impressions and trusting them, maybe we will better understand who we are. But there are a couple of opposing dynamics at work. Even as we learn we have far more sensory ability than we realized, humanity is becoming ever more desensitized in a troubled world. And North Americans and Europeans are spending too much time, as much as 90% of our lives, indoors, cutting ourselves off from nature, which dulls our senses. This disconnect explains why we have been so wanton with the entire ecosystem and ourselves. As science advances and we find out how infinitesimal and fine the workings of our universe are, we must reconsider our place in it, our own bodies, and our own sensory apparatuses. Have we not evolved within this wondrous and subtle and, yes, quantum system? Research is proving that humans are not separate from the universe, standing outside and looking in. We are soft tissue, high tech beings within it, according to anthropologist William C. Bushell. Everyone, from the kindergartner to the trucker on a moonlit highway, has the potential to experience things on this level. In this book, I'll share the testimonies of study subjects and of folks outside of laboratory settings. I'll also share my own experiences as someone on the outer reaches of the senses. I am a synesthete and tetrachromat, super color seer, and a subject of related research. How did this day arrive? In part, the massive investment in virtual reality, augmented reality, mixed reality, and robotics created a golden research era by funding perceptual laboratories. According to Statista, worldwide spending on robotics research is expected to increase from $55.8 billion in 2021 to $91.8 billion by 2026. It is a two-way street. To create realistic experiences, researchers must measure human sensitivity with great precision. The irony is that the huge leaps in technology are upending the way we live and threatening to surpass us. But in this increasingly technological age, we can still celebrate the primacy of human biology. In this time of tremendous change, we must reconsider our perceptual abilities. Humanity is at a crossroads. Some people advocate using implanted devices to become transhuman. This is dangerous and premature, and people are still unaware of their own tremendous power and grace. I'd like to ring the alarm bell with one hand and hit the pause button with the other until we are able to digest all the latest research pointing to our own extraordinary equipment. Many things we seek may be possible through more natural, less invasive means. While I'm not anti-technology, I see this book as a celebration of what is still human and not yet machine. We have severely underestimated our abilities. Using the senses to their fullest potential is every human being's birthright. Adept meditators have long reported sensing on these fine scales, and research shows that meditation improves all sensory abilities. Our perception is tied to emotional health. Isn't it interesting how we say someone is sensitive when we're referring to emotions? There is truth in this. Many people with heightened traditional senses are also exquisitely emotionally sensitive. It is time to create safe spaces for both emotion and perception. There's no such thing as too sensitive. The prickliest among us are often justifiably so. They are the canaries in our collective coal mine, nature's early warning devices. The senses are the ultimate doors of perception, a phrase coined by poet and painter William Blake in his 1794 book, The Marriage of Heaven and Hell. There are gateways, and sometimes portals of transcendence. Psychedelics are often used to achieve extraordinary sensory experiences, and the renewed interest in their value is a sign of a wider sensory renaissance. Yet the power to see the world in a new way is already in us. I urge scientists to find more super sensors among us so that their abilities can be marshaled to help the rest of humanity. The senses are still a largely untapped.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.